Hello and welcome to TamoGraph Site Survey. This brief tour will show you how TamoGraph can help you analyze, visualize, and troubleshoot a Wi-Fi network. TamoGraph can be found at the Tamosoft website at tamos.com. When you run TamoGraph for the first time on a notebook equipped with a compatible Wi-Fi adapter, you will be prompted to install a special driver that will allow the program to read data from the adapter. Installing the driver will take just a minute and, depending on your system settings, might be even performed automatically without any user input. We'll skip this step and proceed to the main TamoGraph window, where we'll create a new project, then survey the site and see how the application interprets collected data. The main window consists of three panels. On the left side, you can see the list of access points that are currently active. The central part is where the floor plan will be displayed. This place is currently empty because we haven't created our first project yet. The right panel is used to manage the project properties. Let's hide it for now and expand the left panel with the AP list. For each AP, we can see information about its properties. The vendor, channel, or two channels, if this is a new .11n AP that uses channel bonding, current signal level, encryption type, maximum data rate, and so on. We'll come back to this panel later on when we need to select APs for analysis. Meanwhile, let's restore its original size and create a new project. To create a new project, we type its name here and go to the next step where we need to select the physical environment. A Wi-Fi network can be deployed in all kinds of different environments, for example in office buildings, hotels, or malls. And for each environment, signal propagation characteristics are different, which is why we need to select the type of environment that best describes the place we are going to survey. In our case, this will be a small office with average signal attenuation. On the next screen, the channels to be scanned should be selected. We can either select them manually or use a predefined channel set for a specific country. We select New Zealand and proceed to the next step, where we need to select an image of a floor plan or a site map. If you don't have a floor plan, you can draw it yourself on a sheet of paper and then scan it. Just be sure to preserve the proportions. Alternatively, you can scan an emergency evacuation plan. Just be sure to return it to where you got it from after having scanned it. We are almost ready to start a survey. The only thing left is map calibration, because the program is not aware of the map scale. This is easy. We just mark a certain distance on the map and enter its length. Here, this wall was measured using a laser measuring tool, so we type the length in meters and click Apply. The scale is set and everything is ready for a survey. A survey is performed by walking the facility with a notebook, and while we walk, the notebook captures Wi-Fi packets and records their characteristics. As we move along the path, we mark our current position by clicking on the floor plan every time we change direction. When we do that, the program draws a circle around the click spot. This is a so-called guess range, in other words, the zone for which wireless network properties can be estimated with a high degree of certainty. Our task is to ensure that the entire office area is covered. You don't necessarily have to walk the entire area during a single survey. You may want to take a break for a cup of coffee or even a siesta. The survey has been completed, so let's show the left panel again. As you can see, we're not alone in this world. There are lots of Wi-Fi networks around, but we know the SSID of our one. That's WLAN03, so we select our APs for analysis. 3 out of 4 APs show up on the floor plan. Such APs are marked with a small blue plus sign. The 4th AP is not shown on the plan because it is located in a different office area, although its signal is still audible. When we hover the mouse over the icon, detailed info about the AP is shown. Those two AP icons located close to each other are in fact one dual band AP that works in 2.4 and 5 GHz bands simultaneously. This is just a small Wi-Fi network deployed in a small office that was chosen for simplicity. TamoGraph can easily handle far larger installations. We are now ready to analyze the data that has been collected. TamoGraph offers many different visualizations, but we'll look at just a couple of them in this brief demo. Let's begin with the signal level visualization. You can see the coverage map where high and low signal strength zones are shown using different colors, which allows you to see the coverage quality in every area. This is just a basic Wi-Fi network quality assessment. Now, to drill a bit deeper, we're selecting the signal to interference ratio visualization. You can immediately see zones with high interference. They are marked with red. Why interference is so high here becomes obvious if you look at the channels being used by our APs. This AP uses channel 6, and this one uses channel 2. But because the second AP is a new .11n device, it uses two channels simultaneously, the second channel being 6. As a result, the signals of these two APs collide on channel 6. This will definitely degrade the performance of the network under heavy load. In situations like that, if interference is caused by an AP that belongs to your network, you may want to simply change the channel. But sometimes interference is caused by a neighboring office, where APs are out of your control. In cases like that, you just draw out a sharp sword, walk into the neighboring office, and... I'm sorry, I got carried away. Another useful visualization shows us expected physical data rate. Blue and green zones reflect high data rates. However, there are also yellow and red zones right next to one of the APs. This looks counterintuitive. The problem is that this is a legacy .11g device that provides the maximum rate of 54 megabits per second. A client located close to this AP would automatically roam to it because the AP would have the strongest signal. So despite being able to connect to high-speed APs that could still provide a better data rate in this area, the typical roaming client behavior will cause an effect that may not be expected. The requirements visualization shows which zones don't meet the requirements set by the user. By default, TamoGraph applies very modest requirements for the signal strength, noise level, data rates, and other parameters, so we see only a very small zone that doesn't meet such requirements. But if we apply stricter requirements, the ones that are typically used in modern high-performance Wi-Fi networks that extensively use VoIP applications and require redundancy in coverage, we'll immediately see many zones that don't meet the requirements with respect to signal level, interference, or data rate. Finally, to document our analysis, we can generate a report. This dialog allows you to configure the information to be included into the report. Select the format, click Save, and in just a few seconds, you will get a professional-looking illustrated summary of your Wi-Fi network analysis. As it has been demonstrated, by applying different visualizations, the user can thoroughly evaluate the network. This can be done during deployment or when the network is already being used. Based on the information provided by TamoGraph, the administrator can make informed decisions, save time, and often reduce his or her budget. Be sure to visit our site and download the evaluation version. Also, feel free to contact our technical support. We'll be glad to answer all of your questions. Thanks for being with us, and goodbye.